Blackstone Audio presents Betrayer of Worlds by Larry Niven and Edward M. Lerner. Wunderland 1. The jungle was eerily quiet. Hugging the uneven ground behind a thin screen of greenery, Nathan Grainer peered over the precipice to where a dirt road followed the narrow, undulating floor of a steep-walled canyon. The suns, one yellow and one orange, were high overhead. Anyone glancing up from the road toward either ridge would only see glare. The perfect time and place for an ambush. The day was cool and a breeze blew steadily. Still, sweat trickled down Nathan's face. Nerves, he told himself, knowing that was at best a half-truth. With the barrel of his laser rifle, he nudged aside a frond for a clearer look. The fern was green, clearly terrestrial. Across the rugged gorge where the second group of rebels hid, the red-gold vegetation was as plainly native. Ruts and potholes scarred the primitive road, no obstacle for anti-grav vehicles, but scarcely navigable for anything with wheels. He wasn't afraid, not exactly. Fear would have required truly believing that this was happening, that he was here. Life had been that way, surreal, since the missile punched through Clementine. The emergency restraints in the pilot's couch had saved him. Everyone else aboard died when the ship broke apart. Resistance fighters reached the wreckage first. Deep in shock, unquestioningly, he had gone with them. He took small, measured sips from his canteen. He took deep, cleansing breaths. When neither calmed him, he looked skyward for serenity, at the birds and their native equivalents soaring effortlessly in the thermals that rose from the plain. That didn't work either. In the resistance camp, he had drawn plenty of sideways glances. The rebels didn't fully trust him, yet here he was. Maybe they had chosen not to leave him behind unguarded. Maybe, finally, they felt comfortable with him. Or maybe they wanted to see if he would bolt into the jungle, given the chance. Would they have let him go? He didn't think so. One way or another, his presence here was a test. A faint droning drifted Nathan's way, and hints of metallic clanking. Over the plain below, in the far distance, where jungle still hid the road, a cloud of brown dust now hovered. Their target approached. The Aristos controlled space around Wunderland more completely every day. Nathan, and even more so his former crew, had learned that the hard way. Snoopersats might intercept even the briefest radio whisper. And so from Nathan's left, where Logan, the leader of this guerrilla band, lay hidden, the most basic of signals, a soft avian trill. Get ready. Nathan whistled an acknowledgement as best he could, not knowing what he tried to imitate. More birdsong to his right and from across the gorge. The gorillas wore camouflage over their improvised armor. Even with their whistles to guide him, he spotted no one. Seven answers in all, including Nathan's own. The crossfire would be deadly. Reviewing what had passed for training, mostly, if it reflects, don't shoot it, and if you see them, assume they see you, Nathan raised the laser rifle to his shoulder. There had been a lesson, too, on improvising explosive devices from household chemicals. Making bombs scared the hell out of him, and he tried his best to leave that knowledge theoretical. Seeing his hands shake, others had built the explosives, now hidden in the ravine far below. Through the scope, he followed the barely a path across the rocky plain below. Not quite trees swayed where the road entered the lower jungle. The first vehicles emerged. Tractors, cargo floaters, flatbed trucks, civilian vehicles all. People jammed the truck beds, balanced precariously on the sideboards, plodded alongside on foot. Another few minutes would bring the caravan into the canyon. Into the trap. Birds circled high overhead, indistinct against the sun's glare. Their presence, perhaps, signified nothing. In his mind's eye, they were vultures. Cranking up the magnification, Nathan saw more women and children than men. Everyone kept glancing fearfully over their shoulders.
He saw a few dogs. And even...
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.